We just made you do an exercise that showed that matrix vector multiply can actually be orchestrated as a sequence of axpy operations. What you hopefully recognized was that you were taking multiples of columns and adding them to the result. Now let's have a look at how that works. We want to do y is equal to a times x plus y. Okay. What you noticed in the exercise was that you should be thinking about a by columns. So let's use our notation to expose the columns of a. See, there are n of them. We also noticed that we were taking elements of the vector x and multiplying those times the corresponding columns of A. So we want to expose the entries of x. And the result of that, we're going to add to vector y, because at every step, we were sweeping through all of y and adding a multiple, and we were adding a multiple of the current column to that vector y. Okay, now let's look at this. If these were just numbers, if this was just a row times a column, then you would recognize this as a dot product, and you would do this times that plus this times that plus this times that. It turns out that the exact same principle applies here. We need to do this column times that scalar plus this column times that scalar, etc. So we get this is the same as a0 times chi0 plus a1 times chi1, etc. But then it turns out that if you do a column vector times a scalar, that's the same as doing a scalar times the column vector. So this is actually the same as chi0 times a0 plus chi1 times a1 and so forth. And now hopefully you're starting to see where the axpies come in. You start with a vector y. You add to it chi0 times a0. Then you update it with chi1 times a1 and so forth. So what you really have is a loop that goes over the columns of a, the elements of x, and at each step you do a scalar times a vector added to the vector. You may have at some point wondered why in the world matrix vector multiplication is defined the way it is anyway. If you go back and you look at some of the linear algebra books you may have encountered, or if you go and you look at the massive open online course we have on linear algebra, you find out that it actually is this definition of matrix vector multiply that makes sense, that motivates why it is defined the way it is. And the algorithm where you take dot products of rows with vectors is actually kind of unnatural. But the important thing here is that you recognize that we can compute y as a sequence of updates involving the columns of A. Now, why is that important? Because in the last section, when you were playing with the orders of the loops, you noticed that if you march through matrices by columns, then you tend to end up with a higher performing implementation than if you march through the matrices by rows. Notice that if you cast matrix vector multiply in terms of dot products, then you're inherently using rows of A, so you're marching through memory in non-contiguous stride. While if you use this axpy-based approach instead, then you end up marching down the columns of A, and that's a good thing.